Morena on this fun Friday. Today is August the 20th and it's Fun Friday. And today we are going to have a Zoom class meeting. So looking forward to that. You'll notice that there's no teaching video today. It's just a story video and I've got a really good story that I think you will enjoy. And you can see sitting on my couch behind me are my two friends, Charlie and Elliot. They are our twin bears that we have in our house and they've been sitting up in the window upstairs watching out for children and waving to them as they passed by. See if you can give Charlie and Elliot a wave now. Okay, today's story is called The Girl Who Cried Wolf. Now I know some of you have been reading in your groups and we've read the story Peter and the Wolf. This one's a little bit different. The Girl Who Cried Wolf. "This is boring," screeched Princess Arabella, throwing her knitting on the floor. Princess Arabella stomped over to the window and looked outside. A shepherd was sitting in the sunshine, watching his sheep and looking ridiculously happy. The princess suddenly had an idea. I wonder if you can predict what that idea might be. I'm just going to move that out of the way. Tom the shepherd boy, who was shocked when he saw the princess and her soldiers marching up towards him. Trembling, Tom knelt down in the mud. "We are swapping jobs," announced Princess Arabella. "From now on, I will be the shepherd and you will be the prince."
"The prince?" cried Tom. "But I don't even know how to be a prince."
"Oh, it's not hard," chuckled Arabella. "Tell me, what does a shepherd do?"
"Well, you look after the sheep, and if a wolf comes along, shout, 'Wolf! Wolf!' as loud as you can, and the townsfolk will come to help you," replied Tom.
"Oh, how exciting," cried Arabella. So Prince Tom was dragged off to the castle. Meanwhile, Arabella, the shepherd, sat down on a log to watch the sheep. She watched them and watched them, but the sheep didn't do anything except eat and poop, and there was no sign of a wolf.
Soon Arabella was bored, so she decided to play a trick on the townsfolk.
"Wolf! Wolf!" she screamed at the top of her voice.
In minutes, the townsfolk came rushing up the hill, waving forks and flaming torches to scare away the wolf.
"Princess, are you all right?" cried one of the men.
"Oh, sorry, your high, I mean, shepherdness," stuttered the man. "But where's the wolf?"
"Oh, it seems to have gone now," Arabella said sweetly. "Off you pop. Thanks for coming."
Charlie and Elliot are looking a bit shocked that she was telling fibs.
"She's telling lies," Tom shouted angrily. "There wasn't a wolf."
"I stink of roses. Can I go back to being a shepherd now?" Tom asked the maid.
"Oh no," said the maid. "It's time for you to ride your new pony."
Arabella, still chuckling to herself, went back to watching the sheep, but wasn't long before she was bored again.
"Bear! Bear!" she cried as loudly as she could.
"Where's the bear?" gasped the townsfolk.
"Oh, you were too slow," giggled Arabella. The townsfolk didn't believe her and wandered back, muttering crossly.
"She's lying again," cried Prince Tom, who was being forced to eat fancy food. "I really wish I could go back to my old job," he sighed.
Sounds like Arabella's a bit of a spoilt princess.
Arabella soon got bored again, and this time she shouted, "Troll! Troll!" at the top of her voice. The townsfolk came puffing back up the hill, looking hot and puzzled.
"Where's the troll?" they asked.
"Oh, I scared it away," cackled Arabella. "I poked it with a long stick."
"So where is it now?" they asked.
"Oh, it'll be over that hill by now. It was very fast."
It was a very fast troll with running shoes on," Arabella cried.
The townsfolk didn't believe her at all and angrily stomped down the hill. Back at the castle, Prince Tom had a visit from the townsfolk. They'd had enough of Arabella's lies. "But what can I do?" cried Tom. "I can't make her tell the truth." "No, but as a prince, you can decide whether we should run to help her every time she shouts, 'Wolf,' or 'Bear,' or whatever it is next," said the townsfolk. "Well," smiled Prince Tom, "I think you should ignore the new shepherd next time. She has told too many lies." "Yes, your highness," the townsfolk replied, bowing low. I wonder if you can predict what's going to happen. Sure enough, a few minutes later, there came another shout from the hill. "Dragon! Dragon!" But Tom had seen the dragon from the castle window and was already running fast as he could up the hill. He grabbed a bucket full of water and threw it right in the face of the dragon. Sure enough, a few minutes later, there came another shout from the hill. "Dragon! Dragon!" "Whatever will she think of next?" sighed the townsfolk. They all ignored her and carried on with what they were doing. The dragon flew away, coughing and sneezing. "That was amazing," said Arabella. "You fought off a dragon all by yourself. Where are all the townsfolk?" "Well, you told so many lies that when you finally told the truth, nobody believed you." "I'm really sorry, Tom. Thank you for saving me," replied Arabella. "Do you think we should swap jobs again?" "Yes," said Tom. "You're a useless shepherd." "I know," laughed Arabella. "I much prefer being a princess." And from that day on, whenever Arabella was tempted to tell a lie, she thought of that terrifying dragon. And instead, she always told the truth. And that's a good reminder to us too, isn't it? To always be honest. And I'm sure Charlie and Elliot would agree with that. That honesty is the best policy. So always tell the truth so that when something does happen, people believe you. So that's all for our story today. Have a fabulous weekend, everyone. And I will look forward to seeing you back next Monday. Be kind to your families in your bubble and try and get outside and enjoy some sunshine. Ha-da-da!